Hey guys, you know, I've done a lot of dumb things with money, but nothing I've ever done compares to the scale of this man who holds a current world record for the most money ever lost. And there's rumors that there's a movie in the works about this guy. Without further ado, let me tell you the tale of Adam, who lost $37 billion overnight. New Yorker Adam Neumann is an eccentric person to say the least. Married to yoga instructor Rebekah Paltrow, first cousins with Gwyneth Paltrow, owner of snake oil company GOOP, he was set out on a new get-rich-quick scheme after his latest business idea of making designer clothing for babies failed to get off the ground. So while at a party, our friend Mr. Neumann met a guy named Miguel McKelvey, and they instantly hit it off. Miguel McKelvey, who was equally, if not more eccentric than Adam, spent his whole life living in a cult commune, and together they joined forces to convince the landlord they knew at the time to let them have free rein on a whole abandoned building just so they could fit it out with recycled furniture and power the lights with wind turbines. They called the idea Green Desk, and they slapped up the entire business in the space of an afternoon. With such a quirky idea, they drew on the interest of a few young entrepreneurs looking for small, cheap spaces to work in. So they decided to say screw it and let these people rent out a single office at the time instead of a whole floor like everyone else does. Once the idea took off and they got bored of being eco-slumlords, they simply up and left and let the owner of the building purchase the business right off them. Now, having just sold their first successful business, netting them a cool few million, they founded the now notorious company WeWork and started aggressively and rapidly expanding to other countries and cities, taking out risky 10 plus year leases on buildings landlords couldn't get anyone to rent, thus receiving a discount on the rent money they'd owed. They would let people rent out single offices for as little as $45 a day, and in turn you get access to essential amenities, like all the free beer you could want, a fully stocked fridge, and foosball tables, just to name a few. Most of the income they were receiving from small random startups who were easily attracted to the idea of not having to fit out an office for themselves. This had some experts concerned because most startups are very fragile and most have no cash reserves. Any small hiccup to the economy, see WeWork revenue dry up literally in a day. Somehow Adam managed to keep convincing investors to keep their money coming in to the tune of $100 billion. Now this is where things start to get really insane. With all this money, Adam and his wife quickly became crazier than ever before. They obviously bought the expensive house and cars you'd expect from a billionaire CEO. However, Adam started smoking insane amount of marijuana, to the point where the cabin crew in his private jet forced to wear oxygen masks for the duration of a flight. They took their five kids out of school, only to set up their own private classes in one of the unrented WeWork buildings, and when the teachers reportedly checked into work on Mondays, they would often come in to find the entire classroom trashed due to Adam and Rebecca's friends using the classroom for parties on the weekend. He often missed entire business meetings due to being passed out from the night before. He would force his employees to fly overseas and drink with him, sometimes continually for days on end, and then just abandoning them a few days later, leaving the employees on their own to get back to America. He reportedly would invite prospective business partners to ride with him in his limo, and then kick them out into traffic once he was done talking with them. You couldn't make this stuff up. But that wasn't all. He also paid almost $6 million to trademark the word "we." He loved surfing, but refused to paddle, so he'd hire his own personal boat driver to launch him out into the waves. He installed a high-power industrial air cleaner into one room of his house just to keep the marijuana smoke off him, and his wife bought the newly installed 5G antenna nearby just so she could tear it down because she read somewhere online that 5G waves cause cancer. All this outlandish spending of investors' money started getting his executives concerned. This is mostly because WeWork had never turned a profit and pretty much relied on investor money to stay afloat. Despite this, his company was valued at $47 billion by the end of August 2019. About a week later, Mr. Neumann filed an IPO, allowing the public to buy WeWork stocks in a desperate bid to raise money. While Adam managed to convince a bunch of faceless corporations to give him money, the public didn't exactly share the same excitement. As is probably no surprise to anyone, private traders realized that investing money into a company that has never turned a single profit and was run by a CEO that can't even attend meetings sober was a very, very bad idea. A few days later, the executives at WeWork cut this price in half, trying to get anyone's money. By the 13th of September, business value had plummeted to just $10 billion and still falling. Due to this, they had to lay off employees in the thousands that very day. Adam wanted to bounce back from this loss and continue funding his lavish lifestyle. But on Friday the 20th, karma finally came knocking and Wall Street Journal dropped a huge story exposing Neumann's reckless partying and drug abuse. He was voted out of the company that very next Monday, holding the title of the biggest loss of a private company to this day. It was reported he even voted against himself. I wouldn't believe the last part if it was anyone else, but after all the research I've done on this guy, I'd say it's at least probable. Well, anyway, WeWork got a new CEO, and after some downsizing, they're still holding on, and Adam is reportedly living in his massive estate, currently looking for his next get-rich-quick scheme. We can only hope he stays away from baby's quarters this time. Anyway, guys, thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed, consider leaving a like, or subscribing, and I'll see you next time.